Our third grade students have learned that Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. believed in the idea that although our country has many diverse people, we are one nation and share a belief in freedom. Through his peaceful actions for civil rights, we have also learned that belonging to the same community unites people of different cultures. As part of preparation for today's show, our students participated in the Edison Recreation Department's Injustice Anywhere is a Threat to Justice Everywhere contest. Benjamin Franklin was honored to have two winners, one from fifth grade, Ethan Poon. Let's hear it for him, even though he's not here. And we are pleased to also announce that we had a third grade winner, Avanti Sudarsanan, from Mrs. Kuniyasa's class. Congratulations to Avanti. And it reads, this plaque is being presented to her, Mayor Thomas Lanky, the Edison Municipal Council, and the Edison Recreation Department present, in recognition of student creativity, the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. African American Contest Award. Injustice Anywhere is a Threat to Justice Everywhere. Congratulations to you.
Welcome all of you to Benjamin Franklin School. We are here today to celebrate Edison, our community of dreams.
Yeah.
countries founded upon basic principles.
These principles are democracy, justice, and freedom.
Democracy gives us the right to vote and help decide how a government is run.
Justice is having fair laws
and treating all people fairly.
Freedom is the right to think, speak, and read what we choose.
Our rights are in the Constitution and the Bill of Rights.
But sometimes the Bill of Rights is needed special help from a special person.
This person had their eyes on its land and its people.
They saw that sometimes people had trouble. They were not treated fairly.
This special person wrote books and talked to the government leaders.
And made speeches about the problems he saw.
He knew our country would be a better place if all people were treated fairly.
This special person had a dream. His name was Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Could not play with his friends because they were white and Martin was black.
1944, Martin began to study the Morse code at the age of 15.
1947, Martin was ordained a minister.
1948, Martin graduated from Morehouse College in Atlanta, Georgia.
1953, Martin was in Boston and married Coretta Scott.
1954, Martin became a pastor of his own church in Montgomery, Alabama.
1955, Martin earns his doctoral degree.
1955 to 1956, Martin led a boycott of the buses in Montgomery, Alabama.
1958, Martin published his first book, Star Trilogy.
1959, Martin went to India and met the family of Mahatma Gandhi.
1963, Martin led a march in Washington, D.C. on August 28th and gave his I Have a Dream speech from the steps of the Lincoln Memorial.
1964, Martin was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize, which was a great honor.
1968, Martin was assassinated in Memphis, Tennessee because some people did not like him.
1983, President Ronald Reagan signs a law the third Monday in January was declared an annual federal holiday by the United States Congress.
50s and the 1960s. He fought for equality and justice for all people.
A long time ago, there was a law in Montgomery, Alabama that black people had to sit in the back of city buses. If a bus was crowded, they would have to stand up when white people wanted their seats.
You might ask, what does this have to do with Martin Luther King? Martin Luther King Jr. felt that law was unfair and set out to change it. It all started one day when a tired lady named Rosa Parks broke the unfair law.
All right, folks, let's get up.
Lady, you gonna move? Lady, if you don't give up your seat, you'll have to call that policeman out there.
Go ahead and call him.
Officer, officer!
Lady, if the driver asked you to stand, why didn't you?
Do you think it's right that I should have to stand up for white folks?
I don't know, but the law is the law. I have to arrest you and take you down to jail for breaking the law.
Make a change.
We shall overcome. We shall overcome. We shall overcome someday. Oh,
Martin Luther King Jr. was the second African-American Nobel Peace Prize.
Martin Luther King Jr. worked for peace and harmony among all people. That is why we should celebrate his birthday today.
Are not indicators of weakness, but gifts of significant strength.